Kia ora and welcome to another edition of the Language Fuel Podcast. We're up to season 3, episode 4. We've just had 3 episodes interviewing Jill Hadfield, who's our new English language teaching content editor for the ELT training library that we've got going at Language Fuel. And that was pretty interesting just hearing her, you know, her long career and the different types of things she's done. She's, you know, traveled around the world and taught and, you know, written tons of books. So we're very delighted and just super pleased to have her on the team helping us, you know, develop our English language teaching online training library. Today's episode is a little bit different. We have finished our Celebrate Jill campaign. As you know, if you've been listening, we were giving away, as part of the celebrations, giving away one free annual membership to the ELT training library, and that's now been drawn and given, and the person has activated that. So congratulations to you. You know who you are. If you did enter that draw but didn't win, check your email anyway, because we've just followed up with a little bit of something special for you. So make sure you check your emails. Right, today we're doing something a little bit different, and I just wanted to let you know about the latest course that we've just published in both our ELT, English Language Teaching Training Library, and our self-directed language learning training library. For those of you who are not aware, we actually have two separate libraries going on. And the reason is because they're very different, you know, people who would normally access that. So obviously the ELT training library is for English teachers. Many of you listening are, in fact, English teachers. Fabulous. We also serve self-directed language learners, which are people typically, the people who we're working with are kind of adults. They are English speakers, but they are going, traveling to other countries, usually in the context of a job, working potentially with local community, and need to know, how on earth do I go about learning the local language? Sometimes they're going to communities that don't even have a language school, so they're not able to make use of those types of resources. So the material that we're providing there is, how do you go about learning a language when you might not have a language school? You may or may not have a dictionary, certainly probably not textbooks and things like that. So it's all self-directed language learning. Anyway, so this course that we've just published, which is actually in both because it's relevant for both sets of people, is all about sentence structure. Now you might go, oh my gosh, what a boring course about sentence structure. I couldn't disagree more, partly because I've written it myself. It's one of mine. I think it's really interesting. And what we do to make our courses super interesting is try to tell stories in the courses. So we're telling in this particular course, we're telling the story of Edith. And if you are a premium member, you'll know that Edith pops up occasionally in some of our stories. Edith is a volunteer English teacher. She's kind of finished her main career a little bit later in her life stage, and she's volunteering at the local community center teaching some refugees for free. She is certainly educated, but doesn't have a background in terms of training to be an English teacher. So she's struggling a little bit with some of the grammar questions that the students are asking her. So in this, at the beginning of the course, we see Edith is working with her students, and one of the students says something like, just find my example there, I played chess with my sister on the weekend and she won me. And Edith goes, I know it's wrong, I don't know why it's wrong, and I don't know how to explain that. So we take Edith on a bit of a journey and explain to her how the different sentence types in English work. So we go through intransitive sentences, transitive sentences, ditransitive sentences, and stative sentences. Now, if you have been teaching English for a while, that may be completely familiar to you, in which case, fabulous. You don't need this course, that's awesome. There'll be plenty of other courses for you. If, however, those words kind of think, oh my goodness, what is an intransitive? What's a ditransitive? Then perhaps it is worth going on this journey with Edith to discover how English works and how things change when you add kind of more objects to the sentence. So that's kind of fun. We had a little bit of fun. And it also explains things like, why do some students, when they're learning English, say something like, my dog dirty? To an English speaker, we would be like, hold on, you've forgotten the verb. It's is. My dog is dirty. And to us, it's obvious. You've missed something. You've missed part of the sentence. And we explain things like, well, hey, in many languages, that's a state of sentence, by the way, in many languages, state of sentences do not have a verb. It's actually not even technically a verb. It's called a copula, but I digress. And many languages around the world just simply don't make that kind of construction with the copula or the verb there. So English is a little bit unusual in that respect. So it's totally normal for students who come from these other languages to leave out the is in that kind of a sentence. So it's sort of answering a few questions. Why do students say these sentences that are not quite right? And how do we explain to them how to correctly form that sentence? So we do obviously focus on English and how English works with these different sentence structures. So the question is, why is it relevant also for our self-directed language learners? Well, when you are learning another language, it's vital to understand what kinds of sentences you're learning, because when you get to different sentence types, sometimes lots of things change. So just as a personal anecdote, my family is getting prepared next month. We're going to be traveling through Europe, something we've been wanting to do for a long time. We're going on a cycle tour down the Danube River, starting in Germany, going through Austria, a little bit of Slovakia, and into Hungary, finishing at Budapest. Now, I speak German and have been brushing up on my German, reading a novel, which has really been fun. And the others, so my husband and one of my daughters said, well, somebody better learn Hungarian if we're going to spend some time in Budapest, so that we can ask. So they have been helping themselves to Duolingo and just, you know, doing the self-study on Duolingo. And they've really enjoyed it. I did a podcast a while ago, at least a year ago now, reviewing, you know, how Duolingo works, some of its pros, some of its cons. It's by no means the perfect. There is no such thing as a perfect language learning tool, let's be honest. But there are some fabulous things, like the fact that it's gamified. So there's, you know, you get points for finishing lessons and things like that. So it's very motivating for my husband and my daughter to be learning Hungarian in this way. But if you know anything about kind of language families or anything about Hungarian in particular, you'll know it's very different from English. It's not a Germanic language. So, you know, learning German, an English speaker learning German, that's not nearly as big as a jump as an English speaker learning Hungarian, because the language family is totally different. The structures are quite different. The sounds are quite different, and so on. So it's been slow going, but they've really enjoyed it. Anyway, my husband came, this is a few weeks ago now, came to me. They always think I can answer all of their linguistic questions. Sometimes I can, sometimes I can't, because I don't know the context too well in these random questions. Anyway, he says, I'm really confused because suddenly the sentence structure's changed. The order has changed, like the subject is at the end or whatever. I can't remember exactly what it was. He says, look at all these other sentences. When I've been learning, and then he gives the order of the sentence. Perhaps it's subject, verb, object. Please don't quote me on that. I can't remember exactly the details of Hungarian. I'm not learning it myself. But he had, you know, figured out the pattern, right? We have, you know, subject, verb, object, or whatever it is. And he goes, but look at this sentence that they've just given me on the screen. It's around the wrong way. Why on earth would they suddenly change the structure of the sentence, the order in which it occurs? And I said, well, what does that sentence mean? You know, tell me the translation of what that sentence is. And when he did that, I said to him, oh, well, that's because it's a state of sentence. It's not actually an intransitive sentence. The English translation looks very similar because we have a subject and then an is and then something. But in that situation, it was clearly a stative. And so obviously in Hungarian, the rules are when it's a stative sentence, we have a whole different word order. And then he was like, oh, that makes a lot of sense. And then when he went through that further on that lesson, he could, you know, see the pattern that they were stative sentences. So my point is, that's a classic example of how when you're doing self-directed language learning and you don't have a teacher to explain to you how the language works, you need to understand these rules. You know, you need to go, oh, okay, well, what I'm learning here is a stative sentence. The rules are a little bit different from when it's a different kind of sentence. And so you're going to be doing constantly this analysis of the language that you're learning. Anyway, so that's kind of the gist of how the course works. It's only about 20 minutes. We're trying to keep each course, you know, short and sweet, fun. We've got stories. We've got Edith. There's animations of how Edith learns these things. There's interactive activities, so you can click and learn along with her and so on. So do go and have a look at that. If you're a premium member, you have access to it already. It's in your account, both of those training libraries. If you're not a member yet, not a premium member, why not check it out? Maybe you'll learn something alongside Edith about sentence structures. That's it today. Short and sweet. We try to keep these very short and sweet. We will see you next time and enjoy the course. Ka kite anō.
Thank you for listening to the Language Fuel podcast. For more episodes and to learn what we do at Language Fuel, please visit www.languagefuel.com.